Love the joy. Hey everyone, it's Blue Lizagella. Welcome back to Dark Souls 3. This is my live Let's Play, so just as a reminder, if you're out there watching on any of the live streams currently, my chat will be broken up every hour or so, and that's when I'll be interacting with you, and I'll be interacting specifically with the Twitch chat. So if you're on Hitbox or YouTube, head on over to twitch.tv/BlueLizagella where I can answer your questions and read your comments there. But for the most part, we're just going to be focusing on the gameplay. So let's take a look at the character. Here is Silvarius, level 42, Warrior of Sunlight. Here are my stats. If you want to see any of these more closely, just go ahead and pause the video here and we'll take a look, or you can take a look there. As far as my gear, rocking the Astora Straight Sword, plus 4. I have a longbow, plus 3. I want to switch this out for the Ferris Bow, but I need some more upgrade materials before I can make it viable. Stocked up on some fire arrows. I have the Dragon Crest Shield plus 2, mostly because I goofed and I wanted to use the Grass Crest Shield and I upgraded the wrong one, but hey, such is life. We'll get there eventually. The Sunlight Talisman, and then for armor, I have the Fallen Knight set except the gloves, which are actually the Firekeeper gloves. I just like the look of that. For rings, Life Ring, Estus Ring, and Chlorinthy Ring. And I did switch out Havel's Ring just because I did just some very, very quick anecdotal tests, and it doesn't seem like Havel's Ring is actually dropping me into a lower roll or a lower weight class, so my roll distance doesn't seem to be impacted, so I figure why not just get some more souls as opposed to having Havel's Ring, which isn't doing me a whole lot of good. Here's my hotbar setup. I'm actually going to switch the gold pine bundle for something else, probably let's see, do I have any charcoal pine bundles? I do. I have a couple of those, but I want resin. You know, let's just remove those altogether for now, and we can get rid of those as well. Let's put Homeward Bones actually on this quick bar right here. That seems to be more effective. Dark Sign I'll never end up using, like never. So I can put Repair Powders on there. There we go. Cool. So what we're gonna do to start off, we are gonna make a lot of progress today. That's the plan at least. But first, I'm actually gonna go on top of the building here in Firelink Shrine, because I want to go visit the crows, which I haven't done before. Oh, by the way, I gotta apparently activate this load screen. My understanding, now that someone has told me about it, is this is actually a load screen. So FromSoft is actually hiding a load screen because what they want to do is they want to keep from having to load the outside area if you're not going to go there. And for the most part, as someone pointed out, when you come back to Firelink Shrine, you're not going to be heading outside. So it doesn't actually load this area until you approach the fog wall, and that's when it actually kicks in the loading, which makes sense. It's actually a pretty efficient way of managing their resources. If it had to always load the outside world, you might have longer loading screens when you're warping, or you might actually get some frame rate stutter, some texture pop in, whatnot. But right here is our crow friend.
You. Me, Bicklebee. Me, Bumperum.
True verbal artist right here. Pickle Pea and Pumperum. Alright, so what can we trade? I am guessing rubbish, which I have some, right? There we go. So let's leave one of those, see if they like it.
You.
No.
No.
You don't want rubbish? That no Pickle Pea?
That no Pickle Pea.
That no Pumperum.
That no Pumperum.
Okay. Alright, give me my rubbish back. Let's try a couple other items. How about an undead hunter charm? Nope, you don't like that. Okay. How about a coin? I don't know what Pickle Pea or Pumperum is. Alright, batting 1,000 here. What else could we try? How about a green blossom? Okay, you're killing me here, Smalls. What do you want? A prism stone. Every bird loves stones, right?
Pumperum.
Yes! Pumperum. There we go, there's one. And what'd you give me? Ooh, a twinkling titanite. That is worth it. Now, I'm assuming we can't do another one, but I do want to check. No, okay, so you only accept one, and that's fine. What else? So, if you like, I don't know, are we doing silky smooth? Like, what? How about cracked red eye orb? No, you don't like those. Just try a couple more items. I'm sure that there's a complete list already out there, but I just don't know what they are. How about a tongue? You want a tongue, you weirdo? Nope, you don't like tongues. What else could we try? An ember? No, it seems like that's something I would get from you. How about a branch? How about a branch? I mean, you're a bird. You're going to use branches for nesting, right? No? Come on, lady. I can't believe you don't like rubbish. Who in the right mind would bother carrying this around? Perhaps you need help. Yeah. Well, previous games told me that the bird would take it. How about bug pellets? I mean, you're a bird, right? You want to eat a bug? Alright, never mind. So we got a twinkling titanite, but that's about it. Well, that's not about it. That's literally it. So that's a shame. We'll have to do some more digging around, because at least the previous birds, you know, they wanted warm and soft, they wanted silky smooth. We could actually kind of glean from that what they wanted, but pickle pea and pumperum, I got nothing. I have absolutely nothing. So at the end of the last time, we did go around and talk to all the NPCs, so I don't have any need to do that. So instead, we're just gonna jump right back in. So let's see, we just did the Abyss Watchers. We could do the Cathedral of the Deep, or wasn't there another area? Pit of Hollows. Okay, I could go to the Abyss Watchers and go into the Catacombs. We're actually going to go into the Cathedral of the Deep and start there today. Let's do it.
You. Me. Pickle pea. Pumperum.
Weird birds. What do you want? What does pickle pea mean? I mean, is that supposed to tell me what you want? I mean, pickle pea. All right, pickles are green. Pea isn't. If it is, then see a doctor. So do you want just green things? The color of pickles? I don't know. Did I already hop down there and get an item? Probably. Probably did. Actually, maybe not. There's quite the path. Who? Hold on. Who is this? Who is that? Oh, man. Do you guys see that? There's someone totally running through the woods. And he didn't look like a ghost. He didn't look like a player phantom. Interesting. Curiouser and curiouser, as they say. Crest shield, okay. Try a plunging attack. That's a really far jump for a plunging attack. So we just got a crest shield. This, I believe, is Oscar's shield, right? A knight's shield engraved with a crest. One of the enchanted blue shields, a crest greatly reduces dark damage. 100% physical, good dark defense. Really good, 86% dark defense. So very situational. So we definitely have a collection of shields that are very situational. So Dragon Crest Shield, 100% physical and 89% fire. 100% physical, 86% dark. Stone Parma, pretty all around, but better stability than the others. Silver Kite Shield, not terribly great. This is pretty standard. Okay, so we don't have a whole slew of them, but we do have two shields. So if I have dark or fire, I do have two shields that are really, really good against those. Yeah, Oh, there's the guy running. That's interesting. He looks like another player. Very, very intriguing. Let's see, how can I safely hop down? This doesn't look like too far of a fall. There we go. You, hey! Nope, that was supposed to be a jump attack. Nope. Wowza. Okay. Trying to go for a parry. Come on. No. Come on. There it is. There's the parry. We both missed. That was kind of great. Ooh, that was swanky on your part. Oh, hey. Oh, the kick. Oh, the kick. I'm actually trying not to heal against this guy. I feel like I'm trying to play honorably. Oh. Oh, he's gonna wreck me though. No. Oh, he's got me. He's got me. All right, that's fine. I'm gonna take it. I'm gonna take it. I'm gonna accept that death. I'm gonna, oh, but you know what? I shouldn't have because I only have two embers left. Okay, that's all right. I'm gonna run without using an ember for a little while. Oh, and, oh, this is where you came from? You have some stamina for days, buddy. All right, we're healing. We're not playing your game anymore. That bleed damage, though. All right, good night. Good night, sweet. Ooh, more ashes. Paladin's ashes. So it looks like we can go give this to our merchant friend and get some more inventory, which is cool. And where did those ashes go? Oh, you're going to be a key item. Umbral ash of a worn-out paladin who sought the Cathedral of the Deep. With this, the shrine handmaid will prepare new items. This paladin paid quite a price for his headstrong justice. It actually looks like he's holding one of the talismans. Kind of cool. Kind of cool. All right. Proceeding. But there's more to explore. I dig it. So many paths. This actually could have been a good place to set up a plunging attack. They did a great job at giving you alternate ways of going into combat. I appreciate that immensely. So many areas. Pointless ahead. Well, yeah, kind of, but still, awesome terrain. You gotta dig it. Make sure no one's gonna plunge on me. That's the last thing I need. Hello, shiny. Titanite shard, absolutely. Gorgeous view ahead. I guess. Maybe you're going that way? I don't know. Doesn't look that great. And up here, is this treasure ahead? I already hopped down there and got the treasure. That was where the crest shield was. All right. Ooh, war cry. Okay. Got a brigand here. What are you doing, man? Oh, you're fast. Oh, he has a spider shield. Well, I handled you a little bit better than your friend there. And he dropped the spider shield, which should have some really, really good poison resistance. A shield bearing a large etching of a spider. Shields of this style are commonly used by savage mountain bandits and offer high resistance to poison. And this gives you the weapon skill, weapon arts, which means that if you're holding this and you actually use the parry animation, which is left 2 or L2 on my PlayStation controller, then I'll actually use the weapon skill of whatever my right-handed weapon is, which is pretty cool, actually. Pretty cool. I haven't found the best usage for that yet, but I still dig it. Alright, some sort of creature over there on the right. Make sure I'm not going to be ambushed as I go and investigate. What do we have? Oh, it's just a pup. No big deal. We have more dogs, more enemies. Ooh, a lot more dogs, actually. Nelly. Okay. Whoa, 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 whoa. Hey, hey, hey. You there. The fire and the crossbow. Am I safe? Yeah. Alright, let's heal then. That guy's taking aim now. Watch it. Watch it. Alright, I don't want to... I just don't want to rush in there. So, I am thinking... Get that dog's attention. Who is writhing in agony, apparently. Good. Got him. We get him again. Got him. Perfect. I don't know, maybe it's just me, but I am finding bows to be way more helpful in Dark Souls 3. Oh, cancel that. Got the dog coming. Come on. I'm right here. There we go. I see another dog, so I still don't want to rush yet. Oh, stupid hitbox in that tree. Oh my gosh. So the tree has a hitbox twice its size, but the actual enemy himself, he just has a completely normal hitbox. Ooh, right between the dog's legs. Alright, I want to save some. Just playing this safe. Come on, pup. Let's heal up. Alright, now, what else do we have? There's another guy. There's another dog. Let's deal with him first. Let's see if we can get him. Oh! Are you dead? No, you're not dead. Now you are. Alright. Time for Nestus. I think now we can head up here and at least get that item and probably snipe a couple more dogs. Although I only see one more right now. Alright. Alright, pup. I think it's just you and I right now. Gotcha. What about down here? Anything? Or is this just kind of a loop around? Yeah. Okay. Just a little ravine you can kind of hide in. Okay, what do we got? Looks like a really, really easy place for an ambush to take place in. But nothing so far. Standard hollow ahead. Visions of charging. Uh-oh. Oh. Oh, he just set himself on fire. He just immolated himself and then charged me. That was kind of interesting. Okay, pathway up to the left. And they're praying to some sort of obelisk. Anything hiding? No. All right. Let's go up here then. You guys friendly? Can I don't want to kill you, but you guys aren't letting me get to that item, so it's gonna have to happen. Sorry. Whoa! No, 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 not the fire. Okay. cast a shard. Yes, great. I wonder if that's kind of a hint. Maybe they weren't praying to the obelisk, but they were actually praying to the Estus shard. So I can hop down there. I don't know that I want to, because we have too many options already. We can go straight or we can go up here. We're going to go up. Typically, I go up when I can. Oh, okay. Hollows coming out of the ground. A lot of hollows. My goodness gracious. Okay, that was very effective. Killed three of them. Back up, back up. Can I? Nope, not through there. Okay. Whoa, 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 careful. So many. I mean, they're very weak, so that's okay. But they're actually coming up behind me too, so it's going to be really easy to get surrounded. Are they? They actually might just be coming back indefinitely too. They might be indefinite. Maybe there's like a necromancer or something that's keeping them spawning. Alright, well. Guess I kind of look at how many. Oh, nope, nope, nope. Get through them. What do we have up here? Alright. A Astora greatsword. That fits my build, considering, you know, Severus is from Astora. We'll take a look at that in a moment, but I need to kind of keep my wits about me in this area. Okay, there's another drop down. Don't want to do that just yet. So many. But I'm just thinking maybe I'll... Whoa, okay. Thinking maybe there's a reason they keep respawning, and just eventually if I get to the right area or kill the right enemy. Executioner's Greatsword? Oh, my heavens. And a Fading Soul. Wow. What? That's disgusting. They just literally jumped out of their own skin. And you have a lot more health. Missed, missed, missed. Am I getting... I am... Whoa! I am getting some souls for these guys, but really not enough to make it worth it. Ay, caramba. Alright, I think I need to top off here. Clear a little path. Wowza. Okay, here we go. Not you. Oh, that crow just scared me. So it looks like this just might have been an easier way. You kind of avoid the items, but you also avoid a lot of these zombies. Ugh. Okay. Nope, don't need to deal with you. Run away. Run away. Alright, So far, so good. So far, so good. Nope, nope, nope. Ooh, almost got grabbed. There's got to be a way to prevent them. has to be a way to prevent them from coming up. But for now... Oh, I might have made a mistake. There's a lot of items down here, but there's a lot of the guys, especially the ones who have transformed. Bait and attack. I don't know what I just heard, but it wasn't... couldn't have been good. Oh! Oh, it's another giant throwing his spears. Is he helping me, though? Where is it? Is it coming from the same giant from previously? It might be. I honestly don't know. Alright. Soul item. Oh! Is this another white tree? You just gotta keep moving. Gotta keep moving. That almost hit me. Yeah, I don't think he's not aiming for me. Young white branch. Yeah, so this is another tree of dusk, I guess. That's at least what I'm gonna call it. Don't wanna hop down. Undead bone shard. Yes, that is for leveling up my Estus flask. Some repair powders. Careful, careful, careful. Is that everything here? Another young white branch. Quickly. That's it. Alright, we looted this area. Let's go up those stairs. Quick, quick, quick. Alright. Nope. I just did a shoulder stab. There's no way I can pretend that was a proper backstab. That was an odd hitbox, to be sure. Oh man, so many options here, so many options. Look around for loot. It's funny because it seems like FromSoft, more than any of their previous games, is encouraging you to not fight every enemy, especially with these assumedly non-stop spawning enemies. Curse Ward Great Shield. Come on, tell me that's not a Pursuer Great Shield. Go ahead and tell me. Great shield given to those who resisted the curse long ago. Far too heavy for an ordinary person. Perhaps it signifies the foolishness of resisting the curse. And yet, those who bear the weight of the shield will not find its protections against curses wanting. Okay. Guy, I saw some blood stains. Oh, 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 can I kick this ladder down? Some sort of shortcut? Praise the shortcut. Well, I don't even know that it's a shortcut. I haven't been down here yet. But now I can explore this lower section. I bet this is one of the areas I could have jumped down to. Whoa, whoa, whoa! What are you? You don't stagger. You don't stagger. You do not stagger. Gotta keep that in mind. Let's go low. Let's go low. Hopefully I don't get poisoned. Oh. Ooh. That meter's still going up. That meter's still going up. Why is it... What's happening? That was... Why am I still... I have leeches on me! What the heck? Do I have to roll them off? I'm covered in these leeches. They're sucking the blood right out of me. How do I get rid of these things? Fire? Oh no. This isn't good. How do I get these things off me? This is disgusting. Get off! I don't have an anti-leech medicine. Oh no. They really just don't go away? What if I splash around in the water? I don't know why that would work. I mean, leeches love water. Nope. That's not doing it. So I'm just dead now? These just don't go away? They're finally gone. Maybe it was water. Bleeding, therefore try torch. Oh, okay. That makes sense. So if I actually have a torch at the ready, maybe I would have burned them off. Okay. We'll give that a shot. That makes some sense. Some semblance of sense was made there. This is also like the Leechmonger in Demon's Souls. Obviously a much smaller version, but I can see the similarities. Really weak to fire. All right, I'm covered in leeches now. So let's pull out the torch and see. Whoop. That is brilliant. That is an awesome mechanic. And as simple as that is one of my favorite things so far in Dark Souls 3. That's awesome. Saint Tree Belvine, the Witch Tree Belvine we found in Dark Souls 2. Sacred chime for casting miracles of the gods, a belvine cut from a small saint tree that has been meticulously tended to. Saint Tree Belvines are customary in the far north and allow for faster casting than ordinary sacred chimes. Okay. So is this... I can't use it because I need 18 faith. Okay. Might use that as opposed to the sunlight talisman.